Hi, my name is Scott Kelly, and I'm an astronaut aboard the International Space Station. What I'd like to show you today is where we sleep, and they are called crew quarters. And we have four here along the both walls, the ceiling, and the floor. And this is a node 2 of the International Space Station. Mine is located on the ceiling right here, and I'd like to welcome you inside and show you around. This is the inside of the crew quarters, and although it's located on the ceiling, because the floor is by my feet and the ceiling in the crew quarters is by my head, it doesn't feel like I'm sleeping on the ceiling at all. It just feels like I'm sleeping in any of the locations, normal orientation, I guess you could say, on the International Space Station. In here, we sleep. This is where we get our change clothes, we do brush our teeth and shave and those kind of things. We also take a little sponge bath. We don't have a shower here on board the International Space Station, so we have to use like a sponge bath. And we also do some work. So we have two computers in here. One's more of a computer for connecting to the onboard systems and particularly like email and procedures. We have a program called World Map, where we can see where we are over the Earth, managing all of our picture taking, and also our schedule is also on this computer, our timeline. And this other computer here is for accessing the internet on the ground. And it's sporadic and pretty slow at times. It is actually a nice capability to be able to get on the internet real time, send emails and receive emails from my normal work email account if I desire to do that, to maybe get on some online banking if I need to do something like that. You could actually even buy a present if you needed to. Sleeping is done on the wall here in a sleeping bag. It's a very comfortable way to sleep once you get used to it. At first, it's can be rather difficult, but once you get the hang of it, it's actually really comfortable, more comfortable than on Earth, for me at least. I sleep much better up here than I do in my own bed at home. And so even though you're floating, I guess because it takes a lot of the pressure off your body, it's actually rather comfortable. Some holes here for your arms, and I sleep just like this. And if I don't zip the sleeping bag up far enough, sometimes I float into the computer and it wakes me up, which isn't fun. So I try to get the sleeping bag zipped up far enough. Some people like to be kind of secured against the wall with bungees so they feel like they're more in a bed. But I like sleeping just kind of floating here like this. Sometimes I put my hands together. It seems more comfortable. But it's a great way to sleep. I get easily 6 to 7 hours sleep on a good night. But if we're really busy, sometimes less, unfortunately. But like I said, better than I do on Earth. What else are we doing here? We have a telephone. It's kind of like a Skype phone. It's voice over IP. Basically just uses the computer. And as long as we have the proper satellite connection, we can call anyone on the Earth just using these Bose headsets and this microphone. Like this. Very, very convenient. As far as clothes are concerned, we don't have a whole lot of space here, so all the clothing we use in 6 months is probably what you could fit in one large suitcase. A shirt generally lasts you about a month, pants maybe 2 months, underwear, anywhere from 3 to 5 days, socks about a month, and workout gear about a month. but you know, it's really odd. For some reason, you don't feel like the clothes get that dirty. The environment's pretty nice up here, temperature, humidity-wise, so you don't really sweat in the clothing that you're wearing. And then you're not necessarily up against your body all the time because you're kind of floating inside of it. So it doesn't, you know, I would never consider wearing a shirt or a pair of pants, shirt for a month or a pair of pants for 2 months at home. But for whatever reason up here, it doesn't seem too bad. Also have some books. It's kind of nice to be able to read in space, something you don't really get to do on a shuttle mission. So I got a couple books here, one by one of my personal heroes, Ernest Shackleton, about his endurance expedition to the Antarctic, and another one called The Long Walk, about a group of people that escaped from a prison camp and basically walked across the continent of Asia to get home. Also have some personal pictures up here, but I took them down for this, for privacy reasons. In any case, I hope you enjoyed the tour here and kind of got a sense for what it's like in our living quarters aboard the International Space Station. Thank you.